Joining us now to discuss is Principal of Wesley Wealth Management, Christy Smith. Christy, thanks for joining us. And before we get into some strategies, thinking about retirement, let's just talk about today's market. And let's say someone calls you up, they're very panicked about what they're seeing. They turn on Yahoo Finance, some other news network, and they say, wow, everything's bad. I mean, how do you talk someone through letting them know that one bad day on Wall Street is not the end of the world?
Well, I think, first of all, we really shouldn't build our investment plan based on emotions ever. I think it's really important that when we create an investment plan, we create a diversified plan that basically we understand the level of risk tolerance that we have. I think, unfortunately, in today's world, a lot of people truly don't understand what the word risk tolerance means, because I think it can actually mean more than one thing. It can mean, how much can I emotionally afford to lose, or how much can I financially afford to lose? So I think it's really important that when you're creating a long-term plan, you don't create a plan that you're going to push the button and trade at any moment truly based on emotions.
And Christy, what are the strategies that you implement when determining what the right retirement planning steps are for each specific investor?
Well, I think we use different tools, of course, for every individual situation or every person. We do believe that for a long-term investment plan, we need to have actively managed money. We typically like to use either institutional funds or ETF funds for our managed accounts, maybe some individual stocks, depending on the person's risk tolerance. But we do believe that right now, we could end this great ride that we've been on for a long time at any moment. None of us really know when that's going to happen. And so I think it's important that we focus on building lower volatility portfolios for retirement. I'll give you an example, because a lot of times people think that when we say lower volatility, we mean lower overall money long term. But in reality, lower volatility can actually mean more money in your retirement plan. Let me just give you a quick example. Let's pretend we bought one individual stock for $1 million, and let's say after a year's time, it was a great stock. We made about 60% on that stock. Mm-hmm. We think we're sitting like a king, right? We're happy with that. In year two, the market turned and we lost about 40%. So let's say over a two-year period, we went from $1 million down to $960,000, but we have an average rate of return of 10% per year. What we like to do is we like to build lower volatility portfolios where we still have a solid average, but yet we're not going to have the big upswings and downswings. For example, in year one, instead of making 60% return, mm-hmm. maybe we only made 40% return. In year two, instead of losing 40%, maybe we only lost 10%. In reality, it's still a 10% average return portfolio over a two-year period, but we simply have more money. And so I think it's important that we look at alternatives in investing. Mm-hmm. we use fixed indexed annuities often in our retirement strategies. Right now, we're using them as bond alternatives, but that's not always the case. Every individual situation is different.
Christy, I just want to ask what some of the most common mistakes are that you see when folks come to you with, retirement accounts that they've been managing on their own. Let's say they had a 401k through work, or they set something up on their own. What are some of the errors that you find yourself correcting when someone signs on as a client of yours?
Well, one of the biggest things is that people really don't understand the level of risk that they have. We like to determine what is someone's true risk tolerance, and we use a software program that's designed to tell us how much risk can they actually afford to be at and emotionally afford to be at. And so one of the biggest things that we see when people come to us is when we run that riskalyzed portfolio on their current portfolio, we find that their risk is way off what their risk tolerance truly is. And that's a big issue, because if you take a 15-20% loss more than you really could have afforded to, it can have a long-term effect in retirement. So I think determining someone's true risk tolerance is really critical, because I believe it's one of the biggest mistakes people make in retirement.
All right, Christy Smith, thanks so much.
Thank you.
And that was Retirement Ready, brought to you by Fidelity.